بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله تعالى فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله عز وجل به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل ربه حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم صلي وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، الحمد لله my brothers، والله العظيم it is one of the most beautiful sights I have ever seen in my life to mashallah see such a gathering of my Muslim brothers. That wallahi, after spending maybe one day with you, I can say in confidence, you represent, mashallah, the elite or some of the elite of our Muslim society in Australia. My brothers, my heart is full of words. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give me permission. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to assist me, to help me, to make you understand what I want you to understand today, inshallah, my brothers. My brothers, we were not created in this dunya by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for enjoyment and wasting time. My brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the greatest, did not create us in this dunya to get married and eat and drink and have kids and build houses and buy cars. The kuffar, people that don't have iman, people that don't have knowledge, people that never received the message of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, share these same qualities with everyone. My brothers, we are a special ummah. We are a gifted Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And for this, my brothers, we have a responsibility. My brothers, we are honored. Like we just heard from our beloved Shaykh, mashallah, in the hereafter, on Judgment Day, we will have Rasulullah on our side. The intercession, the shafa'ah, al-maqam al-mahmood. My brothers, do not ever think in your life that this rank in the hereafter, that this privilege in the hereafter comes for free. My brothers, like this ummah is the first ummah to enter paradise. Like this ummah is the ummah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the most concessions, the most exemptions compared to all other nations. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala requires a certain standard of iman from this ummah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us a lot, my brothers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you everything you have. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, without you choosing, without you begging, made you part of the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It does not come for free. It comes at a cost. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deals with this ummah, my brothers, like we are the beloved ones compared to the other nations. We are the special ones compared to the other nation. But, my brothers, if this ummah disobeys Allah, neglects Allah, leave the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then this ummah becomes lower than animals. This ummah becomes lower than cattle. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أُولَٰئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ بَلْهُمْ أَضَلُّ. They become worse than cattle if they leave this beloved deen, if they leave the sunnah of the beloved Prophet, and they follow the desires and the shahawat and the worldly things, the jannah of the non-Muslims, we are fighting them for it. Our jannah is there, my brothers. If we leave our jannah and fight over this jannah, forget the orders of Allah, forget the sunnah of Muhammad sallam, then we are worse than cattle. And we deserve punishment in the hereafter, not the mercy of Allah. My brothers, this ummah has to wake up to itself. People in Australia, you have to wake up to themselves. Our youth, our people have to wake up to themselves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my brothers, gave us everything. Allah gave you the wealth you have. Allah gave you a mother and your father. Allah gave you your kids. Allah gave you health. Allah looks after you while you're asleep. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking for very little. Allah wants love. Allah wants respect. Allah wants glorification. Allah wants reverence. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu udhkuru Allah dhikran kathira. The order of Allah, my brothers, not neglect Allah. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam warned us The Prophet of Allah warned us. Our teacher warned us, my brothers. قَالَ إِنَّ الدُّنْيَا حُلْوَةٌ خَضِرَةٌ. Verily this world is green, attractive, alluring. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ مُسْتَخْلِفُكُمْ فِيهَا. Allah has created you as generations to follow one another in this dunya. Why, my brothers? To play? To buy houses? To wear G-Star and Reebok and Nike? To fight, compete with one another in who has the fastest car? Why are we here, my brothers? لِيَنْظُرَ كَيْفَ تَعْمَلُونَ. Allah wants to see what we will do. How will we react? What do we prefer? The dunya or the akhirah? Do we prefer Allah and His Prophet or the shahawat of this world, my love, my brothers? The shahawat of this world, desires of this world, the money of this world, the attractions of this world. Allah wants us with Him. Allah wants us to love Him. Allah wants to prefer Him. MashaAllah, our brothers spoke about love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brothers, a clarification that we all have to wake up to. The requirement of deen, the requirement of deen in the hereafter is not only to love Allah and His Prophet. We all have to wake up to this fact. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to love Him and His Prophet and this deen more than everything else in this world. It is not enough. If I ask any of you, like the Shaykh said, we all claim love of Rasulullah. We all claim love of Allah, and it is true. We are not pointing fingers at anyone. Yes, you have love for Rasulullah. Yes, you have some love for Allah. But the question is, my brothers, is this love we have in our hearts enough love to overcome the love of the desires of this world? This is the question, my brothers. Do we love Allah and His Prophet more than things of this world? Do you love Allah and His Prophet and His deen more than your wife? Do you love Allah and His Prophet and His deen more than your money? Do you love Allah and His Prophet and His deen more than your house, more than your car, more than your kids? This is the question, my brothers. How do we know? How is Allah testing us? Every single day, my brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests these facts. Allah puts you in a situation where you have to make choices. Either pleasing Allah or pleasing your wife. Either following the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or running after money like non-Muslims. Either following, serving the deen of Islam or making your kids live like kings in this world. Every single day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests us. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the authentic hadith, ثَلَاثٌ مَنْ كُنَّ فِيهِ وَجَدَ حَلَاوَةَ الْإِيمَانِ. Three things, if they exist in a believer's heart, he will taste the sweetness of Iman. Isn't this our complaint, my brothers? Isn't this the complaint we find abundant? Very, very, very famous. Very common in all of us. Brother, wallah, I come to Salat, but I'm not feeling anything. Brother, wallah, I read Quran, but I'm not feeling the beauty. Brother, wallah, I love giving da'wah, but it's not coming from my heart. It's a very, very, very simple answer, my brothers. We don't have the sweetness of Iman in our hearts because we have not fulfilled these conditions. Number one, أن يكون الله ورسوله أحب إليه مما سواهما. To love Allah and His Prophet more than anything else in the world. Not equal, not the same. If you meet Allah and you love Allah like your kids, you don't have the correct requirement of Iman. If you meet Allah and you love Him exactly like you love your wife, something is wrong with your Iman. You have to prefer Allah and His Prophet. How do we know, my brothers? Every single one of us who pleases his wife by displeasing Allah, who makes more money by displeasing Allah, who leaves the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to please people around him, or make more money, or get some worldly gain, has proven through action that he loves these things of dunya more than Allah and his Prophet and the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Through action, love is by a'mal. This ummah has to do to thank Allah. اعملوا آل داود شكرا. Work, O family of Dawood, work to thank Allah, to show gratitude to Allah. وقليل من عبادي الشكور. Little of my slaves, a very, very little number, are thankful and grateful to Allah, my brothers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly says in Surah At-Tawbah, and please open your hearts to the word of Allah, the greatest subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are not the words of an extremist sheikh. They are not the words of some alim who's making tafsir. Clear, direct words of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ tell them, يا رسول الله, إن كان آباؤكم وأبناؤكم وإخوانكم وأزواجكم وعشيرتكم وأموال اقترفتموها وتجارة تخشون كسادها ومساكن ترضونها, say to them, يا رسول الله, if your fathers or your sons or your brothers or your wives or your families or money, business or your houses or merchandise, any of these things, if any of these things, my brothers, is more beloved to you than Allah and His Prophet and struggling for the deen of Allah, فَتَرَبَّصُوا, then wait, for the punishment of Allah is coming to you soon. فَتَرَبَّصُوا حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ اللَّهُ بِأَمْرِهِ وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْفَاسِقِينَ. Allah does not guide the fasiqeen. We're all struggling in our own community to practice deen in our own household. How do you expect to save these people from Jahannam? How do you expect to save humanity from everlasting torture if we ourselves, the Muslims, struggle to practice our own deen, my brothers? We have an amanah. We have a responsibility. Every single one of us has to wake up to himself and realize the load he has on his shoulder. True, we are privileged. True, we are the closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, provided that we practice the orders of Allah, we fulfill the conditions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس. You are the best of nations sent out to people. Our job should be out there, my brothers, to bring people to the guidance of Allah, not struggle with our own practice of deen, our own following of sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس. What do? Play cards, play PlayStation, race, mashallah, in drag races, go fishing every weekend, spend thousands of dollars eating out you and your family? No. تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله. You order the people to do good. You take them to guidance. You forbid evil, corruption from happening. And you believe in Allah. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu says, whoever wants to fall under this ayah, let him fulfill its requirements. If you want to be from the best of umam, you have to be that person. You have to be that leader. You have to be that guidance. You have to be miftah lil khayr, the key for goodness and khair around you. Not the key for evil. Not the key for harm. Not the key for corruption. My brothers, when will the day come when we look around us and we find, mashallah, the youth of the ummah of Muhammad sallam leading by example, practicing deen properly? Men like the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, the Sahaba that were around Rasulullah, my brothers, they changed the world. They took Islam to a level, it became mumakkan fil ard. Most of the world was under Islamic authority when the Sahaba radiallahu anhum were men. When they practiced this deen, when they loved Allah and His Prophet more than everything else in this world, they put Allah and His Prophet before anyone, any pleasure of family, of wife, of kids, deen came first. Order of Allah came first. We come here, we still have to play, you know, massage people, be nice to them, comfort them. Allah da alayk, brother, please repent to Allah. Please stop. Please this, please that. Alhamdulillah, we will try our best. We're all trying our best. But my brothers, there has to come a point for this ummah to wake up to itself. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum lived in Islam sometimes less than most of us, my brothers. Sa'd ibn Mu'adh radiallahu anhu, the leader of the Ansar, 7 years only Muslim. Only 7 years in Islam. From the day he accepted Islam till the day he passed away. 7 years, my brothers. But when he passed away, in the authentic hadith, اهتز لموته عرش الرحمن, the throne of Allah shook when a man passed away on earth. Because he was a man. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my brothers, loves us. Allah gives us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He sees in your heart that you prefer anyone in the world over Him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is jealous. I created Him. I gave Him everything. I gave Him wealth. I gave Him that thing He is in love with. I gave Him that thing He is preferring over me. And He neglects me and follows dunya and desire. Billah alaykum, brothers, is that justice? Is that justice that our Muslim ummah struggles to pray the 5 times salat in the day? Is that justice that we struggle to follow the sunnah of our beloved Prophet the man who wallahi is the best man to ever step on this earth, will leave his sunnah and follow the sunnah of people who don't know anything about this dunya, who have zero ilm. We follow them, we love them, we act like them, we talk like them, we dress like them, we live like them, we yearn to meet them, we will die to get a signature or an autograph, and we leave the sunnah of our Prophet. Is that brains? For Allah's sake, my brothers, I don't want to take much more of your time. For Allah's sake, wake up to yourselves. Realize the responsibilities you have. Realize the seriousness of the matter. إِنَّهُ لَقَوْلٌ فَصْلٌ وَمَا هُوَ بِالْهَزْلِ. Allah is not playing games with us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned us. وَيُحَذِّرُكُمُ اللَّهُ نَفْسَهُ. Allah warns you from Himself. Beware the anger of Allah, my brothers. You don't want to be in the hereafter, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry with you. This ummah has to wake up. Make this your night, my brothers. Make intention in your heart, without showing off, without telling anyone, that never from that night onwards, any point in my life, I will put anything over the deen of Allah. Anything should never take preference over the orders of Allah and the sunnah of our beloved Prophet. Number one comes Allah's pleasure, Allah's orders, Rasulullah's orders, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The sunnah of our Prophet comes first, and then come all the other people around me. If we do this now, you will see a change in your life. Allah will make us the leaders of the world. Allah will open the barakat, the khair on you, the blessings from the heavens and from the earth. But my brothers, make the right choice. Repent to Allah, return to Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like He promised, whoever comes to Him walking, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes to him running. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who practice what we hear. Us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أن يجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه.